It's in the same
Oh my
year.
God. This is a company uniform.
Guys, things are going great.
He just idolizes Roxette.
He's a beautiful schoolgirl, Paul Blart.
Yep, he's a magical girl.
He's a magical girl. in a magical world.
He's just been watching so much anime that he's like very into it now.
Now, Julia, you realize by doing this, you have invoked a new DM rule.
Which is
if we roll another 20, Paul Blart transforms into magical girl Paul Blart.
Right. Excellent, because he's
just
out now.
Regular schoolgirl outfit, but yeah,
right.
He does the spinning transformation.
Yes, exactly. He does a full Henshin. This is great. I feel like this entire episode was partially inspired by playing Breath of the Wild, aka Link's dress-up simulator.
Yeah.
That's my favorite part about the game, is
getting
outfits.
When you spend 40 hours getting the materials to buy a new tiara for your favorite boy.
Yeah. He needs it.
I rolled a 20.
A 20, yeah.
Paul Blart.
I hand Paul Blart over to you.
Nathan, you're out. Yeah. Lexi, you're now in possession of the Blart pack. What do you do?
I put it on top of my newly alive spider Jeffers.
Oh, I thought this was going to be like a Hodor situation where you'd be on his back and he would bring you places.
Oh, that could be fun too.
Oh, so you're the backpack.
So I'm the backpack.
I'm into that.
He's on top of Jeffers and I'm on top of him. We're like a little tower.
Oh. Great.
You're unstoppable. I guess you've combined moth dust and an old broken box.
Yeah. Well, there's probably some like bone clown essence still left on there.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay, so what happens is the machine rumbles a bit and then it spits out Boxy, the flying box. And it is a functional box with a face and two wings.
Howdy, I'm Boxy!
No.
Yes! Join the Tower of Power, Boxy! Oh yeah, now that I have Boxy, can I exchange Boxy for an item?
Oh boy, I'm so excited to be your friend.
Are you gonna put Boxy back in the vending machine?
Please, no, it's so dark in there.
Yeah, I think I am.
Oh boy, I love the breath of freedom.
That's great, that's nice, Boxy. In you go.
Where are we going?
He's gonna take that skin thing.
Ooh. One skin thing, please.
Oh, I'm sorry. Let me correct that. That's skin cloak. As if that's any better.
Ma'am, this is a Baskin Robbins. I don't know what you're asking for.
How did it come to be on your wall?
That's a mighty good question.
It's a mighty good question. And Gus explains.
Okay. That
I do have partial face blindness, so I have no idea who most of you are.
Gus says, now, let me look up in my Google Doc with all information.
Could you just like, carry me? If you could just lift me up on your shoulder so I can address you properly, that would be just fantastic.
Regina summons up a bone throne underneath baby Gus that raises him up to our eye level.
Well, this is the spooky-ookiest hot chair I ever did see.
Oh, man. If only I had Boxy.
Old omnipotent voice, you've made a fool of me once again. That's just a load of whippy-whap.
That's not a phrase, Gus.
Hey, Squishy Big Tooth, I know you're not a wolf, but, like, if that's your deal, that's your deal.
Squishy Big Tooth. Squishy Big Tooth's the name.
Oh, my God. Being face. Squishy and having a big tooth is my game. Oh, yeah, I'm a pretty one-dimensional character.
apropos of nothing, this looks like a very conservative cartoonist's drawing of Hillary Clinton.
Is this a game that you personally rented at some point, Nathan?
No, it's a game that my friend had, and he kept leaving inside the boxes of my other games. So I thought I'd gotten rid of it, and then I'd go to play Mario Kart, and oops, there's Zoids.
Jacob, Regina, we're having fun here, but this just reminds me of Boxy.
Yeah, wait, speaking of Boxy, where is the old devil? Come on, come on out here. I paid a pretty penny to get you over here. You know, the legends say he'll finally bring peace to this realm.
Oh, God. Regina just looks at Lexi yeah. and, like, just shakes her head no, like, keep it quiet.
There's another group of adventurers that has wandered in and said they're on a quest to they're on a quest to find Boxy, the legendary savior of our world. Oblard has become Maho Shoujo Maldoka Magikop.
Anime is the binding force of the universe.
Yeah.
Across all earths, across all planes.
I have the power of God and anime on my side. You're a Gerard Butler.
Perfect, yes. All right, you enter the store, and you see Gerard Butler. Ow. I've injured my hands quite badly.
Well, time for me to go.
Harry takes one look at Paul Blart's magnificent mustache. I'm sorry, Maho Shoujo Maldoka Magikop's resplendent mustache and says, I must shape that.
Maybe someday I'll get you a body.
Hey, you know, I'm not going to be needy.
Does it ever make you mad that I could do that at literally any time and I choose not to?
I cope with humor.
Listen, here's the thing about Regina. She knows that crimes are incredibly cool to do. I'm going to give you a roll. Here's Regina's sneaky thief roll.
Ah!
I have some bad news. All right, Nathan, I'm going to give a first name. You want to give a last name?
Yeah.
His first name is Hurt.
Okay, and his last name is...
You got this.
Locker.
Hurt Locker. Hurt Locker, the famous fighter.
Okay, so in this mall, we have Gerard Butler and Hurt Locker.
And Harry.
The stars are out tonight.
I didn't mention, but Harry's last name is Styles.
Okay.
That's how you lure the kids in. Then you hit them with some real horrible snails.
It's a salt shaker. This is a shakedown.
Excuse me, do that in the appropriate voice, please.
Oh, no, it's a shakedown.
Jonathan, please, this is a serious moment.
I feel like Magical Blart seeing a crime being committed in a mall is just, like, rearing up, and Legsy has to sort of soothe him like
yes.
a horse.
He's fucking ready to go. So, yeah.
Whoa there. My random power is... the ability... Power activation. The ability to activate latent powers.
Okay. Aw, dang, I forgot about this banana.
Now my whole bag smells like old, gross banana.
Yeah, and your, like, social studies notes are ruined.
Now I'll fail the big test.
But then the teacher's like, one question, what do bananas smell like?
like
but he didn't say
is
it.
Is this, like, all Blart?
It might
oh
be it might be all Blart. I think what happened is, so I went to, because I was still part of the Blart stack. So I think what happened is Blart got in there when I smashed the Wiki Tiki and the.
We just gave Paul Blart a new form, and now.
Every episode he changes.
He's ascended yet again? Holy.
He's going to become
fuck.
The new god of this realm.
Oh my God.
He's already in the mall, which is his, like...
Domain. Yeah.
This is amazing. Paul Blart is going to be the god of this universe by the end of this adventure.
The one I found that I think is the one I'm going to go with. The number one worst reviewed game, it has an 8 on Metacritic, 8% out of 100, is a game called Big Rigs Over the Road Racing.
Wait, are you just going to summon a truck?
Yes, I am, but... I need to read for you an excerpt from this article.
Okay.
It says, Big Rigs was released unfinished with no sound, no collision detection, and a physics engine clearly designed in another plane of existence. You can't even lose the game, as each race ends with a man standing next to the words, your winner.
You have to give that big rig a superpower is the thing.
Yes. So it's sort of like an intangible glitch truck.
An impossible glitch truck
piloted by a man that screams, "You're winning."
So
good luck trying to stop me with a blockade, copper. I've got collision detection turned off. Life's a glitch, then you die.
There we go.
Jonathan, this is serious. I'm part of the truck. Yeah, if I were Hollis and I looked out the window and saw giant magical girl Blart, a truck glitching in and out of the geometry of the world, and then in the middle of it all, Rock's just sitting there having coffee with her dad, I'd probably give it up.
You can hit me with that power whenever you want. I'm ready to draw dead.
Okay, all right. This is probably going to impact your drawing a little bit. Your superpower is explosion vision.
It's going to make reading books hard. Maybe Quadzo made his prosthetic.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yes. One,
the only arm he's ever made was for Rox's dad.
A special favor for an old friend. I think that they definitely went on an adventure together, too. All three of these dads.
Oh, probably. There was probably a dad quest at some point.
Oh, man. I love these dads. I love these dads.
I'm ready to fight. Oh, my God. I'm filled with sandwiches. I'm ready to fight.
I had to look at the word recapybara for the past 15 minutes, just waiting for that joke to come out of here.
It was worth every
minute. It was worth every time. It's also the only misspelled word in the thing, so it's underlined as though it's like, please look at this Caldwell joke.
But the rudest monster of them all is, of course, Bronson Craster, and they begin loudly addressing you.
Hey. What are you doing in my woods, you bastards?
We're just trying to pass through these woods. We're on our way to Climax Mountain, where I think something climactic will happen.
So I'm holding this snail, and I look to my friends, and I'm like, would this be a good present?
What's up?
Would this be a good present for Tiffany?
Oh.
I don't imagine Tiffany wants this.
Dope.
Are you
sure?
And
I just chuck him into the woods.
Oh, no.
Hey, miss.
Excuse me.
Excuse me. Hey, miss. Hey, you want a duel? You're beautiful.
Oh, no.
Caldwell, you're always afraid of Ringus.
Who's not afraid of Ringus? You should be afraid of Ringus. Mm. They're doing that thing that lizards do where they lick their eyeballs with their tongue.
I hate that thing. It's like, just get eyelids if you need to moisten them. Have eyelids.
Some people aren't born with eyelids. Lizards don't got eyelids, right, Gina?
But then they shouldn't have eyes that need moisturizing.
All right, you got me there. That's a very
good
point.
That
it's God's mistake.
An ignorant point of view, right, Gina?
He fingers his last capture cube.
Mm-hmm.
And...
love fingering that cube.
Come on over. Help me get untied.
This seems like a trap.
I'm getting trap vibes, heavy trap vibes.
Yeah.
You gotta hurry. Like, Pukenichi is gonna be back any second. We gotta get out of here.
It's just like the spotlight on you and everything. It really feels like...
Yeah, I can't see anything else in the room. It's rough stuff, I'm not gonna lie.
Francis activates the machine, and everything begins to burn.
Ow. Owie.
Oh, no.
You become this glowing triangle in the infinity of the cosmos. And as you drift, you suddenly feel someone else. It's Daryl.
Daryl.
We found him. He was in the cosmos the whole time.
Who's this?
Stop.
Hey, can you stop? Could you stop?
What are y'all up to?
Trying to stop this sort of inevitable end to all creation.
Oh, would you look at that? That is no good. Gotta learn to get outside of your comfort zone.
I don't like failing.
That's why, you know, this year at summer camp, you know, once kids went to bed, me and all counselors went down the mud pits, just got wild on drugs. Aw. Actually, what if I just make the whole thing like a sum?
That looks like it would hurt to hold.
Well,
it
here's does. The thing. Here's the thing, though. If the song doesn't work, you just beat the shit out of whoever you find. He's on. Oh, who's this? Oh, my goodness. It's Boxy.
What? Boxy?
I'm back, too. Hooray.
What? Where? How?
You must have your whole own story.
Don't worry about it.
Yeah, you can talk openly about beating his ass and he won't notice.
I would talk openly about beating his ass regardless of his consciousness.
Yeah, I kind of wish he was still awake so that we could talk openly about beating his ass.
I whisper in his ear, I'm going to beat your ass.
fast, huh?
I'm gonna beat your ass so bad, dude.
You see that he's like nuzzled up against Daryl, and like he's got a little smile on his face. Doesn't even seem to notice.
That's real cute, but it's not gonna be cute when your ass gets beat.
He's just happy that his brother's back. He just did it all to save his brother. I would do some deception to save one of you guys.
They weren't brothers, were they? Are they brothers?
Are they brothers or just lab partners, I guess?
I thought there was romantic interest there.
Oh, maybe.
They're snuggled pretty close together, Legsy.
They're snuggle brothers, that's for sure.
I guess Legsy had her own headcanon, but...
Legsy misread the situation.
Legsy super misread the situation. Wouldn't be the first time.
Aww.
Won't be the last.
Legsy got the Funimation Sailor Moon dub.
I thought your engineering degree could help me get the proper trajectory on like the best downward punch to like punch Porfo back into the thing he's crawling out of.
Finally, this shall be my greatest assignment yet.
And you see that Demon Johnny pulls out a pencil magically. And yes, you see at the end that there is a little eraser shaped like a sandwich. And they start just drafting the perfect trajectory for what they are calling Roxa's ultimate punch. Yeah.
Brilliant pun. I love it. Ha ha. Jonathan the Bone Staff isn't the only one that enjoys a good pun. Ha. Now let's build a trebuchet.
Demon Johnny rules. I want someone this proper and excited about everything in my life.
I call this trebuchet the Bingus.
He's still got that crass sense of humor, though, that I love so
flingus.
Much.
The Bingus Flingus, yeah.
In this situation, Rox, you're the Bingus, and you got to get Flingus.
Demon Johnny says, "You're the strongest person I've ever known, and your strength comes not just from within, but from your friends. And from the exploits that shall carry you to the end of your days."
Damn, he kisses Johnny. You one more time.
That was beautiful.
Johnny, that was so nice.
Now punch the hell out of this big marshmallow.
Oh, I'm excited too.
Little guy's tuckered out.
My next slide was sleep is a great way to recover from being punched really hard. Yeah.
Ah, two brothers reunited.
Wow, goblin culture sure is affectionate towards family members.
Gina, can you explain this to him?
So, no, dude, I gotta beat your ass first. Not explaining shit.
And you see Buttercup the Hoofer Driver carrying Dennis the Shapeshifter, the Pugilax, which is now mounted on Gregory Hamilton's body, the Paul Blart Mall Squad, and all of your fucking dads burst through the wall.
Yeah, Dad Squad. Yeah, this is Francis and his not his brother.
Yeah, sweetie, they're in love.
Right. Right. Yeah. Dad.
Legsy!
Dad!
Legsy!
Dad!
Legsy! I'll be fine.
Okay.
Porfo grabs you and drags you through the portal.
Oh,
stop!
No!
Welcome to Draga, where we tell a dumb story.
With even dumber drawings?
I am, of course, your drawing master, Caldwell Tanner.
This is very somber. I'm Nathan. Your halfling rogue, Lexi Shortstack.
I'm Jacob. Also, Regina.
Wonderful, wonderful.
The Bone Mage.
Hey, it's Julia. I'm your Roxa.
I am Erasus, the Undoing.
Sorry, you're what?
Erasus.
Erasers?
Erasus. I am the god of a universe once, and I shall become the god of infinity.
Is it just me, or does this guy look kind of like a melty Bingus?
What is Bingus?
Can we call him Bingus?
I am Erasus!
You Bingus? Said to call you what we will.
Very well. I am Bingus the Undoing. You three are quite obstinate.
Yeah, we told that.
Kind of our thing.
I have traveled through the cosmos.
That's crazy.
I have ravaged thousands of galaxies.
And you haven't tried butter?
Tell me, what is the tiny gold brick?
Regina.
What's up?
What do you and Roxa think about this scene that's unfolding here?
Gina's just like, there's nothing better Legsy could have picked. Like, Legsy's breakfast is maybe the only reason that I get up in the morning.
Pretty good.
Is this guy kidding me?
Unbelievable.
It's more than pretty good.
This is the philosophical question of our age.
Am I allowed to punch?
Forget, can you pet the dog? Can you punch the bingus?
Yeah.
DJ, do you think I can punch the bingus? Do you think that's advisable?
Is this like a question you should ask me in private?
Yeah, you got a little something on your chest there, man.
When I create universes and destroy them, often there is debris involved. Perhaps it is some remnant, some dust of a former galaxy. Let me inspect.
You just turned down. Oh, I poked you. That's a type of prank that is a sign of great respect.
Yeah, only for our greatest leaders do we reserve that prank.
Such depths of love exist in this universe.
Yeah.
Yeah, totally, idiot.
Call me idiot? Is my name idiot now to you?
No,
very well!
It's still Bingus. It's forever Bingus.
You could be idiot Bingus if you want.
So it shall be. I am the idiot Bingus.
You know this sort of like deep emptiness you feel that's causing you, that's sort of driving you to want to destroy so that you can create, so that you can destroy, so that you can create?
The suffering, yes. It is what makes me a good artist.
Yeah, but like what if you were happy? What if you like decided to be happy?
What
instead?
Is happy is happy butter.
Happy
honestly?
Happy and butter are pretty close.
Who that is?
Oh, is this our newest friend?
I think this might be our newest friend.
Is this our newest
can
friend
guess?
Who's our friend because he didn't destroy our
who's our friend
home?
Because he didn't
it me
didn't destroy our home Bingus it you
didn't destroy
it
our
me.
Home and everything we love
here's your whole like melty Bingus bot.
Hey, thank you so much for your help. I know I can never fully repay you for what I've put through, but I'd like to try.
I deck Francis.
Oh.
I was getting ready to do that.
I give
beat
him a, to it this time Rox.
I give him a dead leg.
Oh jeez, god, fuck.
Rox, get in here.
Daryl, help me out!
Get one in.
No, man, I really appreciate you saving me, but, like, you knew this was coming.
We all get one, Rox. Come on.
Now it just feels like bullying if I join in.
Give him a wedgie. Wet Willy.
I wanted to be the first one. You know what? It's fine. I guess
now, come on, Rox, get in here. Just give me one, please. To be decked by Rox, it would be an honor that I would tell my grandchildren about.
I try to do one of those things where you just kind of like rub the knuckles against, you know, the chin, except I do just wind up punching him really hard.
Are there drugs in these shots?
Normal.
That's not an answer.
Normal drugs.
Cheers.
Cheers. Hey, guys, let's never talk about any of this ever again.
I would love nothing more than that.
I don't remember half of this. So.
I'm just saying, we'll probably have other adventures that we go on, maybe. Let's just never bring any of this stuff into that, you know? Keep moving forward.
Yeah,
kind
you know,
of thing.
I totally agree. We can't get stuck in the past.
Right. Love you. Love you guys.
Love you too.